शुक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटिसम प्रभ निर्विघ्न कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारंभं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा। गुरवे सर्वलोकानां विषजे भवरोगिनां निधये सर्वविद्यानां दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। नारायणं पद्मभुवं वसिष्ठं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्रपराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौडपदं महान्तं गोविन्दयोगीन्द्रमथास्य शिष्यं श्रीशङ्कराचार्यमथास्य पद्मपादं च हस्तामलकं च शिष्यं तं तोटकं वार्तिककारमन्यान् अस्मद्गुरून् सन्ततमानतोऽस्मि। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं साक्षात्कृतं दयानन्दं परमार्थस्वरूपिणं तत्त्वज्ञानप्रशास्तारं प्रणतोऽस्मि परं पदम्। ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ भद्रं कर्णे विश्रणुयामदेवाः भद्रं पश्ये पाक्षभिर्यजत्राः स्थिरैरङ्गैस्तुष्टुवाहुंसस्तनूभिः यशेमदेवहितं यधायुः। स्वस्ति न इन्द्रो वृद्धश्रवाः स्वस्ति नः पूषा विश्ववेदाः स्वस्ति नस्तार्क्ष्यो अरिष्टनेमिः स्वस्ति नो बृहस्पतिर्दधातु। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ ब्रह्मादेवानां प्रथमः सम्बभूव
ॐ ब्रह्मादेवानां प्रथमः सम्बभूव
विश्वस्य कर्ता भुवनस्य गोप्ता स ब्रह्मविद्यां सर्वविद्याप्रतिष्ठां अथर्वाय ज्येष्ठपुत्राय प्राह अथर्वणेयां प्रवदेत ब्रह्मा अथर्वातां पुरोवाचाङ्गिरे ब्रह्म विद्याम् भारद्वाजाय सत्यवहाय प्राह भारद्वाजोऽङ्गिरसे परावराम् शौनको ह वै महाशालः अङ्गिरसं विधिवदुपसन्नः पप्रच्छ कस्मिन्नु भगवो विज्ञाते सर्वमिदं विज्ञातं भवति इति तस्मै सहोवाच द्वे विद्ये वेदितव्ये इति हस्म यद्ब्रह्मविदो वदन्ति परा चैव परा च तत्रापरा ऋग्वेदो यजुर्वेदः सामवेदोऽथर्ववेदः शिक्षाकल्पो व्याकरणं निरुक्तम् छन्दो ज्योतिषमिति अथ परायया तदक्षरमधिगम्यते यत्तद्रेश्यमग्राह्यमहोत्रमवर्णम् चक्षुश्रोत्रं तदपाणिपादम् नित्यं विभुं सर्वगतं सुसूक्ष्मम् तदव्ययं यद्भूतयोनिं परिपश्यन्ति धीराः भाष्यं वि केन् रीड् वक्ष्यमानं बुद्धौ संहृत्य सिद्धवत् परामृश्यते यत्तत् इति अदृश्यम् अदृश्यम्
अदृश्यम्
सर्वेषां बुद्धीन्द्रियाणां अगम्यम् इत्येतत् दृशेः बहिः
प्रवृत्तस्य
पञ्चेन्द्रियद्वारकत्वात् अग्राह्यम् कर्मेन्द्रिय अविषयम् इति एतत् अन्वयः मूलम् इति अनर्थान्तरम्
इति
अनतान्तरम्
अगोत्रम्
अगोत्रम्
अन्वयम् इत्यर्थः
अन्वयम् इत्यर्थः
नहि तस्य
नहि तस्य
मूलम् अस्ति
मूलम् अस्ति
येन अन्वितं स्यात्
येन अन्वितं स्यात्
In the last class, we saw up to this line. This mantra, important mantra. All the words are important. Adreshyam. Adreshyam is equal to adrishyam. We saw that is chandasam. Adrishyam meaning that which is not available for the sight perception. Not only for sight. We can extend to the other sense organs. Buddhindriyanam agamyam iti etat. Drishehe bhagif pravrtasya panchendriya dvarakatvat. This drishehe bhagihi. This vritti, vritti jnanam, vritti means thought. Any jnanam, any knowledge, it takes place in the form of thought in the buddhi, in the mind. Any jnanam is only in the form of thought. There is no thoughtless knowledge. Any jnanam takes place in the form of the thought, the cognition in the mind. For the thought, for the cognition of an object to take place, the objects have to enter the mind. The objects have to enter the mind. But we say the vritti, they go outside and pervade the object. Go outside through the sense organs and pervade the object. And the thoughts which are illumined by the Chaitanyam, Chidabhasa, and since the thoughts are illumined by the Chidabhasa, therefore the Jnanam takes place. For the Jnanam to take place, this vritti have to pervade the object passing through the sense organs, the doors of sense organs. Therefore, panchendriya dvarakatvat. Since panchendriya are the dvaraka, the gates, the panchendriya cannot objectify chaitanyam, chidabhasa. So, five sense organs are the gates, by through which the vritti goes out and envelops the object to be objectified, and the vritti gets the rupam or the color, whatever may be the object, and that vritti is illumined by Chaitanyam, and the knowledge takes place in the buddhi. This is how the knowledge takes place. Now, The knowledge of Brahma, how will it take place? How will it take place with the help of sense organs? It is not possible, because sense organs, they are only the gates, the gatekeepers, the guards. The guards, they don't have access to the inner apartments of the owner. The owner is the Chaitanyam. So therefore, sense organs cannot objectify the Brahma, the Chaitanyam. Because Brahma is not one more object which the sense organs can objectify by allowing the Chidabhasa to pervade. Chidabhasa is the object of knowledge for sense organ. It is not possible for sense organ to objectify it. Brahma being oneself, therefore it is not available for objectification of the sense organs. So therefore, drishyege bhagihi pravrittasya panchendriya dvarakatvat buddhindriyanam agamyam. So the hetu and etumat is given. Agragyam, it is not available for karmendriya. It is karmendriya avishayam. Agragyam, karmendriya avishayam. Karmendriya means the organs of action. It is not available as the vishaya for the karmendriyas. Not available for hands, not available for legs, not available for any karmendriya, pancha karmendriya. So therefore, it is agrahyam, not graspable. You cannot hold it. You cannot hold it by hand. You cannot have the knowledge of that using any karmendriyas. Similarly, agotram. We saw this. Na gotram agotram. Nanch tat purusha samasa. Gotram, anvayaha, moolam. All these are pariyaya shabdaha. That's what Bhashyakara says. Iti anartantaram. Artantaram means anya artaha. Anya artaha artantaram tat purusha samasa. Na artantaram, no other meaning. It means not different meanings. They are not different. They don't have different meanings. Gotram, anvaya, moolam, these three are pariyaya shabda, synonyms. They don't have different meanings. So na artantaram, anartantaram. Anartha means not useless, but it's not the meaning here. Artantaram, na artantaram, anartantaram. You should not split anartha plus antaram. Not that way. Artantaram, na artantaram, anartantaram. Artantaram is anya artaha. Na anyartaha, ananyartaha, anartantaram. So gotram, anvaya, moolam, all these mean the same thing. So gotram is the family, the lineage, anvayaha, moolam is the root. The root of the family, which is indicated by the word gotra. Gotra starts from the grandson. From the grandson onwards, gotram starts. Grandson must have a father, and father must have is the father. For him only this is a grandson. Agotra, when we say, it means the initiator of the family not there. Moolam not there. Nahitasya moolam asti yena anvitam syas. There is no root by which you can connect the Brahma to that. It means Brahma is parentless, doesn't have any initiator. It means it has not come into existence through something, through the parents. There is no ancestor. There is no ancestor. Therefore, agotram. It doesn't have a parent. Therefore, it doesn't have a family. It doesn't belong to any particular family. Doesn't belong to any particular family because it doesn't have ancestor. The gotram not there. Therefore, gotram not there means it means Brahman is rootless. It doesn't have roots. It means it is the root of everything, therefore doesn't have roots. It is the root of everything. It is a karanam of everything. But that itself doesn't have a karanam, agotram. It is sarva karanam. Therefore, it is karana rahitam. It is the causeless cause. Karana rahitam. Sarva karanatvat. Sarva karanatvat. Karana rahitatvat. Agotram. The word agotram means that. Then the next line. We can read. Avarnam.
Avarnam.
Varnyate iti varnaha. Dravya dharmaha.
Dravya dharmaha.
Stulatvadayaha.
Stulatvadayaha.
Shuklatvadayova.
Shuklatvadayova.
Avidyamana varna yasya tat. Avarnam aksharam.
Avarnam aksharam.
Avarnam na vidyate varnaha yasya tat. That which doesn't have varna. Varna means color. We can take the meaning of color first. So it is free from varna. So the literal meaning, the meaning of the word varna is color. Pachyartha is color. So Brahman is colorless. Brahman is colorless. It is colorless. Colorless also is different from the thing which has color. So colorless, when you say, there is another thing called color. It is colorless means it is above color and colorless. You cannot say it has color, you cannot say it is colorless. It is neither dark or neither fair white. So no such color. At the same time, you cannot say colorless. It is a cause for all the colors. It is the cause for all the forms. So, all the colors are in that. At the same time, it is doesn't have any color. So, avarnam is varna ragitam. Varna is only the word by which the Upanishad says it is Brahman is nirgunam. Guna ragitam. Varna is a guna, it's a quality. That is why varnyate iti varnaha. That which have qualities. Varnyante. Varnyante iti varnaha. That those which are described, that by which an object is described is called a quality. An object is nothing but its quality. Any object in the world, what you objectify with your sense organ, it is nothing but the quality. It is only an adjective. You cannot really objectify the object without the qualities, without the adjectives. What you perceive in the world is nothing but the qualities alone. The sense organs can perceive only the qualities. So it is only the interaction with the qualities, not with the substance. With the substance you cannot interact. The substance being Brahma, how can you, the Brahma, can interact with Brahma? When you see an object, say for example, you see the flower, rose flower. A rose has got parts, many parts are there. The rose has got many parts, stem, petals, filaments, and the petals are having colors. If you take the petal alone, it has got a shape, that is a quality. It has got a color, it's a quality. A and the flower has got smell. It is a quality. Different parts are there. It has got certain shapes. Different parts have got certain shapes. It's a quality. Different parts having different colors, quality. So what is a rose minus these qualities? Minus this quality, rose, you don't, cannot see the rose. Rose minus this. Rose minus the color of rose. Cannot be rose. So what you perceive is only the form and the color of an object. What you perceive a person also, you see the person, you see the form of the person, you see the color of the person, you see the hair, eyes, nose. By this only, you identify a person with a name, so and so. So, nama rupa, only the names and forms by which you identify a person. Rupa and rupa is associated with the name, therefore nama rupa. So, any interaction is only nothing but the interaction with the adjectives, adjectives of that thing. The substance of that thing with which you cannot have any interaction. Therefore, they are saguna, with qualities. With nirguna thing, you cannot have any interaction. No vyavahara possible. No vyavahara possible. So now, about Brahma, whether it is nirgunam or sagunam, it is nirgunam at the same time, it is sagunam at the same time, it is nirgunam. From the standpoint of this jagat, it is sagunam. Minus jagat, it is nirgunam. Without jagat, it is nirgunam. If you ask jagat is there, therefore it must be sagunam. If you say, we will say jagat itself is not there. Jagat itself is not there. Then how can you say Brahma is sagunam? So saguna is only a word what we use because of the empirical reality. Sagunam. Brahman is sagunam and Brahma is nirgunam. But there are Praudavadis. They say, where is Jagat? Jagat itself is not there. He was talking about Jagat. In Mandukya, Gaudapada will say, I don't see Jagat. Where is the Jagat you are talking? What is the Jagat you are talking about? There is no Jagat. What is there is only Brahma. Well, I see so many things. But he will say, I don't see anything. Everything is Brahma. There is nothing called Jagat. That is the vision. That is the vision of the Acharya. It's a Vada. It's a Prouda Vada. Very a grand vision. So, therefore, whether Brahma is saguna or nirguna, it is both. It is both. With regard to the empirical reality, it is saguna Brahma. The Brahma has become as though become, not become. Brahma cannot become. Brahma is in the form of the Jagat available for your transaction. So therefore, sagunam is, sagunam implies the transaction through the dvaitam. So dvaita is not satyam. For the transaction to happen, there must be two things. Therefore, sagunam. So the any transaction is between the two things, it's only through these qualities. So a thing is described by these qualities. Minus these qualities, with the substance, you cannot have the transaction. Therefore, the quality of a thing, dravya dharmaha, the qualities, like stulatvadayaha. Stulatva means grossness, stulatvadayaha, stulatvam, etc. Stulatva denotes the shape, gross or subtle, different objects of different sizes, starting from the mountain, so huge, and to the smallest thing, mustard, smallest thing, mosquito. The grossness are there, of grossness of varying degrees. Similarly, Shuklatvadayaha. Shukla means white, the color, whiteness, etc. All these are the qualities, Dravya Dharmaha. by which a substance is described, over which you can have the interaction, the transaction. Brahma doesn't have any of this. It doesn't have dravya dharma. Stulatvadeha, shuklatvadeha, nasti, brahmanaha. Therefore, avidyamanaha, varnaha, yasyatat. Therefore, varna means this gunam. The gunam, guna, gunaha, nasti. Avidyamanaha means absence. So that which doesn't have these qualities. Varna can take the meaning of varna as quality. Varna we can take the meaning of color. Color is also a quality. Therefore, that which doesn't, which do not have these qualities, or that in which these qualities are absent, that in which the colors, the qualities are absent, that is called aksharam. Tat avarnam. Avidyamanaha varnaha yasya tat avarnam. Therefore, Brahma is avarnam. It is colorless. It is without any attributes, no qualities. Therefore, avarnam. Therefore, aksharam. Doesn't have attributes. Therefore, cannot change. Because it's the very substance of everything. Therefore, it cannot change. Naksharati. Cannot undergo any change in the form of growth, in the form of decay, in any other form. It cannot take any other form also. So therefore, aksharam. And the word varna can also mean this varna ashrama. Chatur varnya maya srishtam gunakarma vibhagashaha. So chatur varnyam, four varna. Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. If we take the meaning of Varna as, Brahma doesn't have Gotra. If it doesn't have a Gotra, how can it be belonging to any of these Varna? Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. It's not a person. Therefore, it is cannot be a Brahmana. It is not a Kshatriya. It is Avarnaha, Avarnam. It is avarnam, agotratvat, because it doesn't have a gotra, therefore it is avarnam. At the same time, it is the varnatitaha. It is above all the varnas. It is above all the varna, all the classes, all the social classes, varnashrama dharmaha. So dravya dharmaha we can take. Or Varnashrama Dharmaha also we can take for the word Varna. Continuing the next line. Achakshushrotram.
Achakshushrotram.
Chakshuscha shrotram cha.
Sakshushrotram cha.
Namarupa vishaye karane.
Namarupa vishaye karane.
Sarvajantonam.
Te avidyamane yasya tat.
Ajakshushrotram.
Asakshushrotram.
Chakshushrotre is Pratama Vibhakti Bivachana. Chakshushrotre, Achakshushrotram, Chakshuscha Shrotram cha, Chakshushrotram, Na Chakshushrotram, Achakshushrotram, Chakshushrotre, Avidyamane, Yasya Tat. So Chakshuha means eyes, Shrotra means ears. Chakshu, Shrotra, these are the Karana. These are the Karanam's instruments. Chakshu, Shrotram. For what? For, these are the Karanam. Chakshu for the sight. Shrotram for the ears. So, for objectifying for objectifying objects, for knowing the name and form of the objects. Nama rupa visaye karane. Nama rupa visaye karane. Nama and rupa. Nama is name. And rupa is form. The name is heard. It is shrotra visaya. Rupa is the form, which is chakshu visaya. So sarva jantu naam nama rupa visaye karane chakshu shrotram. So for all living beings, sarva jantu naam, sarva jantu naam nama rupa visaye karane. For all living beings, this eyes and ears, these are the instruments for all the living beings. For what? For objectification of objects. Object is objectified by its name and form mainly. So nama for eyes and rupa for ears. So nama rupa visaye karane chakshuhu shrotram sarva jantunam. Te avidyamane. These two, te refers to these two. Avidyamane yasya tat. Te avidyamane yasya. Yasya kasya brahmanaha. Aksharasya. Aksharasya te avidyamane. Akshara, which doesn't have these two. Tat achakshushrotram. That is called achakshushrotram. Na chakshushrotram, achakshushrotram. That Brahma, Brahma which has no eyes, no ears. So therefore, since it doesn't have eyes, therefore it is na drashta. It cannot be the seer. It cannot be the perceptor. It cannot perceive. It is not a pramata. It is not a jnata. Pramatratvam nasti brahmanaha. Nyatratam nasti, it cannot know through seeing. So na drashta, not the seer. Not shrota also. It cannot hear also. Because it doesn't have ears to hear. So na shrota. So therefore na jnata. Na jnata. Now, when ears and eyes are not there, when it is not there, and why, what is the reason? Why do you negate them? You don't negate when something is not there. In my hand, nothing is there. My hand is empty. You don't say that pot is not there. Flower is not there. It's not there. What's the point in negating them? Many things are not there. Nothing is there. Then why do you say pot is not there, flower is not there? When something used to be there, if it is not there, you can negate. Brahma doesn't have eyes or ears. Then why do you negate them? You can negate something only when it is possible. When it is there, when the possibility of being there only, you can negate. Prasaktasya eva pratishedaha bhavati. Ato aprasaktasya. That which is not there, there is no need for you to negate. Why do you say that? Father Bhashyakara says later, the next line he will say. Next line we will read. Before that, this jnatrutvam will be there. That is the knowership will be there. Jnatrutvam will be there only when a thing as a jnatratvam for a thing will be there only when it has the when it is shrota or drashta. Only when it is the shrota drashta. Shrotra drashta means seer. So only when it has ears, only when it has eyes to see, only when it has ears to hear, only when it has tongue to taste. Similarly, the skin to touch, nose to smell. Only when these sense organs are there for the sense object perceptions, then only Jnatrutvam will be there. So, Jnatrutvam will be there only when the thing enjoys these sense organs. Yatra yatra Jnatrutvam asti, tatra tatra Chakshuradi Matvam asti, Chakshuhu Adi, that is Indriyas. Indriyas will be there. So, only when Chakshuradi Indriyatvam asti, then only Jnatrutvam is possible. You have all this Chakshuhu, Shrotram, Tvak, all these are there, therefore it can be a Jnata, a knower. Minus this, how will you know? If sense organs are not there, how will you know? You cannot know. So, Jnatrutvam is there only when Chakshuradi Matvam is there. Brahma doesn't have, therefore Jnatrutvam nasti. Therefore, Brahma cannot be a Jnata. If doesn't there, then why you say not there? Why do you want to say Brahman doesn't have eyes, doesn't have ears? What is the need? What is the need to negate when he doesn't have? Because the next line and the next mantra, the next mantra, the Upanishad is going to say. Upanishad knows everything, what is going to come later. Keeping in that mind, in the beginning itself he says. And Bhashyakara also explained this with the words which are going to come in the later mantras. In the next mantra, ninth mantra, you will see. Yes, sarvajna sarvavit, yes, jnanamayam tapaha. The mantra starts, yes, sarvajna sarvavit, sarvajna. Sarvajna means sarvam janati iti sarvajna. The one who knows everything. Who is sarvajna? Brahma is sarvajna. Brahma is sarvavit, sarvam veti. Sarvam veti iti sarvavit. So Brahma is sarvajna. Brahma is sarvavit. It knows everything. It knows everything in general and it knows everything in particular. Because everything being Brahma, it is jnapti swarupaha. It is the awareness, the consciousness which knows everything. The knowledge, the consciousness means knowledge. This jnapti swarupaha, it is in the form of knowledge. That which is self-evident, self-illumining, and the illuminator of all the objects. Doesn't require anything to illumine that. Its swarupam is shining. So doesn't need anything, any other thing to know it. It is self-shining, like the sun. So, therefore it knows everything. Sarvajnaha. When you say Brahma is Sarvajna, knows everything, how does it know? Knowing is possible only through Chakshuradi, Chakshuhu, Shrotradi. Only when this are there, only when sense organs are there, then only a thing can have the knowership. So Brahma is Sarvajna, therefore it must have. No, it doesn't have. That is why Achaksha Shrotram. Even though it is Sarvajna, Sarvavita, it is not in the sense of knowing like us. Brahma doesn't know anything like us. We use the sense organs to know things, but Brahma doesn't have to use. It doesn't have and doesn't need to know also, because its swarupa is knowledge. When its swarupa is knowledge, then what is the need for Brahman to have these sense organs in the form of eyes, ears and all? Not there. It is not there for Brahma. Therefore, Achaksha Shrotram. That Divashikara will explain the next line. You can read that. Yes, sarva, yes, sarva vidh.
Yes, sarva,
sarva vidh.
Iti.
Chetanavatta visheshanatvata.
चेतनावत्व विशेषणत्वाद्
प्राप्तम्
प्राप्तम्
संसारिणाम् इव
संसारिणाम् इव
चक्षुश्रोत्रादिभिः
चक्षुश्रोत्रादिभिः
करणैः
करणैः
अर्थसाधकत्वम्
अर्थसाधकत्वम्
तदिह चक्षुश्रोत्रमिति वार्यते पश्यति अचक्षुः सशृणोति अकर्णः इत्यादि दर्शनात् सर्वज्ञस्सर्ववित् द मंत्र नाइन्थ मंत्र इन द सेम सेक्शन In this Prathama Mandaka, Prathama Kande, is going to come. So keeping that in mind, the Upanishad said Achaksha Shrotram and Bhashyakara also keeping that mind, he establishes why the Upanishad says Achaksha Shrotram. So Sarvajnaha, Sarvam Janati iti Sarvajnaha, that which knows everything. Sarvam Veti It is Sarvavit, that which knows everything. Both are knowledge. Sarvajna Sarvavit means it seems to be same. Sarvajna Sarvam Janati knows everything. Sarvam Veti, only the dhatus are different. One is Janati, other one is Vidhatu. Nyadhatu, Vidhatu. Both means to know. Sarvam Janati, Atava Sarvam Veti. Tayoho Kopi Bedahanasti. Then why should Upanishad use two words, Sarvajna, Sarvavit? One word is enough. For which we give the reason. Sarvajnaha means Sarvam Janati. Because Jnapti Swarupatvat, Sarvam Janati, everything it knows in general. In general, it knows everything. Sarvam Veti, and it knows everything in detail also, specifically also. It knows in detail, very specifically also, Brahma knows. Because it is all knowledge. It is Bhagavan, Ishvara. Ishvara can know. He knows everything. He knows everything in general. And he knows everything in particular. He knows that Jagat is myself. Jagat is myself. That knowledge Ishvara has. Brahma knows that Jagat is myself. And the Jagat which has got so many things made of this Panchabhuta of different categories, different varieties, everything it knows specifically also. Everything Ishvara knows in detail also. That is why it's called Ishvara, Srishtikarta, Ishvara. Hiranyagarbha. What is Hiranyagarbha? We have seen Samashti Buddhi. Samashti Sukshma Sharira Abhimani Chaitanyam Atma Hiranyagarbha. Samashti Buddhi. The sum total of all the Buddhi. Buddhi stands for knowledge. The sum total of all knowledge is Hiranyagarbha. So Hiranyagarbha knows everything. Everything in detail. Only when it knows everything in detail, then only Srishti is possible. So, everything in general is denoted by the word Sarvajnaha. Everything in very elaborately, in detail, that also it knows. Therefore, Sarvavit. So, yes, Sarvajnaha, Yaga Sarvajnaha, Sarvavit. Yaga refers to Ishvara, the Brahma, which is Sarvavit. The Upanishad uses Yaga. Brahma, the word is Pullinga. Sorry, Napumsakalinga. Yaha, the word is Pullinga. How? Yaha refers to Brahma or something else. When it comes to Tattvam, there is no Linga. The word Brahma is Napumsakalinga, but the word Yaha is Pullinga. So, how are you going to say that Yaha refers to Brahma? Yaha or Ya or yet by any word Upanishad can denote Brahma because it is alinga, doesn't have any specific linga. When we talk about it is agotram avarnam, what linga is that? What gender is that? That which is genderless and above all gender. The word itself is like that. Then what to talk of? Brahma. So, yaha refers to Brahma Aksharam. When it comes to Tattvam, there is no linga. And the Upanishad conveys that. It uses the Pullinga word, sometimes the Pumsakalinga word, to show that Brahma is without linga. That is, doesn't have gender. The word and all has got gender only in Vyavahara. What is the gender of the word Brahma when it refers to the ultimate reality? No gender. So, that Brahma, which is Sarvajna, Sarvavit, Ityadi, Pashakara quote that mantra, Ityadi, Chetana Vatra Visheshanatvat. Chetana means Chaitanyam. The sentiency, the Chaitanyam. Chetana Vatra Visheshanatvat. So, Brahma is presented as having this Chetanatvam. This Chetanatvam, Brahman is of the nature of this Chaitanya. His Swarupam is Chaitanya. Visheshanatvat, distinctly. Visheshanatvat, Visheshana means particularly, distinctly, Visheshanatvat. So, Brahma has this Chetanatvam, Chetanatva Visheshanatvat. In the mantra, it is Brahma is presented as the one having this Chetana Vatvam, that is knowership, as a Visheshana. Visheshanatvat. Visheshana means it is not in the Visheshana, it is the Lakshanam of Brahma. Chetanatvam is the Lakshanam of Brahma. So Visheshana means it's a Lakshana. So, even though we translate the word as Visheshatvam as the attribute of Brahma, it is not the attribute like the attribute what we understand generally. It is the Lakshanam of Brahma. The Chetanatvam is the Lakshanatvam of the Brahma. Brahma, which is of the nature of this consciousness. So, in the sentence, there is the Visheshanam is there. Brahma has got the Visheshanam, Sarvajnaha, Sarvavit. These words are adjectives. Adjective to Brahma. The words are adjective, but Brahma cannot have any adjectives. These are the Lakshanam of Brahma that we need to understand. So, since the words Sarvajna, Sarvavit, these adjectives are there, so it means Brahma is aware of everything, it knows everything. In general and in very specifically also. So therefore praptam. Therefore what is praptam? Yasarvajnaha sarvaviti ityadi chetanavatva visheshatvat. Chetanavatva visheshatvat. Arthasadakatvam praptam. Arthasadakatvam means artha prakashakatvam. Artha Prakashakatvam. It is the illuminator. It's the illuminator of everything. Artha Sadagatvam. Artha Sadagatvam Praptam Brahmanaha. So, Brahma has a status of the illuminator of everything because it is Sarvajnaha Sarvavit Iti Chetanavat Visheshanatvat Artha Sadagatvam Praptam. Like what? Samsarinam iva? No. Samsarinam iva chakshusrotrabihi, shrotradibihi karanaihi nivaryate. Not like samsarina, an individual. How does he gain the knowledge of an object? He uses chakshusrotra, these karanas, these instruments. These instruments he uses, that is why he can use and gain knowledge, that is why he is a knower, Therefore, no worship is there for the individual because he has his sense organs and therefore he has the capacity to know and therefore no worship is there. Therefore, a jiva has no worship because eyes, ears, other sense organs are there. So, jnatrutvam asti jivasya because chakshuradhimattvam asti. And therefore, because these are there, similarly, Brahma also, when he says sarvajna, therefore it also must have eyes and ears like the jiva. It's an anumana. It's an anumana, an inference. By inference, we can say Brahma also must be having eyes and ears. Because Brahma also sarvajna. Therefore, jiva also sarvajna. Jiva also can know. Jnatrutvam asti jivasya api, brahmanah api. Therefore, by anumana, we can say Brahma also must be having eyes and ears. That is nivaryate, that is negated. That is negated by the statement, by the word achakshushrotram. That is negated. Brahma doesn't have ears and eyes. Without having ears and eyes, it knows everything. It knows everything. And Vashikara substantiates this by quoting from the another Upanishad, Shvetashvatara Upanishad, Pashyati Achakshuhu. Without eyes, it sees. Achakshuhu means Chakshuhu na vidyate yasya. Tat Brahmanaha. Brahma doesn't have eyes, but it can see. Nash Akarnaha, Karnaha na vidyate, ears not there. Saha Shrunoti. Saha refers to Brahma. Ishvaraha Shrunoti. Without eyes, Brahma can see. Without ears, Brahma can listen. Ityadi Darshanat. These are the quotation from the Shveta Shvatra Upanishad. Therefore, without eyes, it can see. Without ears, it can hear. Without skin, it can touch. Without nose, it can smell. So all the actions which are possible with the help of sense organs are possible without the help of sense organs for Brahma. So what does it mean? It means that in the presence of Brahma, everything is possible. In the presence of Paramatma, by mere presence, Paramatma by his mere presence, he shines, he is self-shining and it is, he illumines everything. Sannidhi matrena prakashayati sarvam. Sannidhi matrena sarvam prakashayati. By its mere presence, it illumines. Therefore, that illumination, the shining, it is not a particular work for. It's not a particular, an attribute or a quality or a work for Brahma. This illumination is not an adjective, not a work, not a quality for consciousness. Consciousness means illumination. Consciousness doesn't need another consciousness to shine it, to make it shine, to illuminate. Consciousness means illumination. By being there, by mere presence, it can reveal objects. Like a light illumines the object. And what light is required to illumine that light? In the presence of light, you can discover an object in the dark room. But what light is required to illumine that light? It doesn't need any other light. It is the illuminator of everything. And it doesn't do any particular job of illumining. It's just there, therefore objects illumine. Similarly, consciousness, the Chaitanyam, Brahma, Ishvara, any word you use, by the mere presence, everything is revealed. What is the effort involved in illumination? There is no effort. It is its Swarupa. That is why in the temple, in the Arati time, you will find in the traditional temple, they chant, Natatra Suryo Bhati Nachandra Tarakam Nema Vidyuto Bhanti Kutoyam Agnihi Tameva Bhanta तमेव तम एव भान्तम् तमेव भान्तम् तस्य भाषा दैट्स इम्पोर्टेंट लाइन तस्य भाषा सर्वम् इदं विभाति दैट मंत्र इज गोइंग टू कम लेटर तस्य भाषा भाषा मीन्स शाइन तस्य भाषा ब्रह्मणः भाषा सर्वम् इदं विभाति एवरीथिंग शाइन्स because of the Brahma. It doesn't need anything else for it to shine. It is self-shining. It is self-evident. When it is self-evident, it doesn't require any karanam. So therefore, without ears, akaranah shunoti achakshuhu pashyati. That is why we say Kenopanishad says Shrotrasya cho Shrotram Manaso Manasaha Chakshuhu. It is the ear of the ears, eye of the eye, listener, the ears of the ear, eye of the eye, mind of the mind. It means the consciousness, the Chaitanyam. It is not a pramata because it is not a pramata. Because it is not a pramata, therefore doesn't have any karanas. No instruments are required. Like a jiva, a samsari jiva required. Samsarinam iva, chakshuhu shrotram. Chakshushrotrabhihi karanaihi artha sadhakatvam, artha prakashakatvam. Nivaryate. So, therefore, Brahma is not a pramata, and also it is not a perceived thing, perceived object. It is neither a perceiver nor can be perceived. These are negated by this, the words achakshu shrotram. Continuing the next line. Kincha. Tat apanipadam. कर्मेन्द्रियरहितम् इति एतत् तत् अपानिपादम् पाणिपादम् पाणिपादौ अविद्यमाने पाणिपादौ यस्य डजंट हैव पाणि पाणि इज हैंड्स पादम् इज लेग्स सो ब्रह्म डजंट हैव लेग्स डजंट हैव हैंड्स सो इट इज It means it is free from the organs of karma. Karmendriya ragitam. Free from the organs of action. Therefore, because it is free from the organs of action, therefore it cannot be the karta, nor can be the karma. Can be a karta. For karta to be a karta, Karta means action. And action is accomplished through karmendriyas. Karmendriyas are not there. When karmendriyas are not there, action is not possible. Therefore, kartrattvam nasti. Okay, kartrattvam nasti, but can it have karmattvam? But also not there. It doesn't enjoy sense organs of action, and it cannot be influenced by the organs of action. So it is neither the subject nor the object. Nainam chindanti shastrani, nainam dahati pavakaha. Shastrani, pavaka, all these things cannot bring a change, a cause in it. All these things, shastra, astra, this pavaka, so these things cannot do anything to Brahma. What about apa? Apa also na kledayanti and marutaha na shoshayati. All these shows that Brahma cannot be a karma, an object. It cannot be an object. Na hanyate hanyamane sharire ajo nitya shashvatoyam puranaha na hanyate hanyamane sharire. It cannot be an object of action, it cannot be the subject. The kartrutvam also negated. Karmatvam also not there for Brahma. Therefore only, therefore, yataha.
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 Evam agragyam agragakam cha.
Evam agragyam agragakam cha.
Yataha.
अतः
नित्यम् अविनाशी
नित्यम् अविनाशी
अविनाशी
ब्रह्म इज अग्राग्यम इट इज नॉट ग्राग्य वस्तु नॉट अवेलेबल फॉर कर्मेंद्रियास टू ग्रैब कर्मेंद्रिय रगितम कर्मेंद्रिय ज्ञानेंद्रिय रगितत्वात् इट डजंट हैव एंड एनी कर्मेंद्रिय ज्ञानेंद्रिय आल्सो कैन नॉट ऑब्जेक्टिफाई it is not available for objectification and it also cannot objectify. It is above all. So agragyam means it is not an object of karmendriya or jnanendriya. Agragyam. Agragakam also. It is not a karta. Kartritvam also negated. So it cannot be a karta, it cannot be a karma. Agragaka means the one who grasper the subject. Agragaka, not the subject. Gragyam means that which is grasped, object. Gragyam. Agragyam, that which is not possible to grasp. Agragyam. So neither the karta, neither the karma, neither the subject nor the object. Therefore, if it is neither the subject nor the object, then what is that? It is advaitam. Advaitam Brahma. There is no subject-object duality. Dvaitam nasti. Dvaitam, the word is there only in the Vyavahara. It's just a word. It's an empirical word for the empirical transaction. Because it is there in the Vyavahara for our empirical transaction, therefore we say na dvaitam. Dvaitam not there for that. Not possible. For dvaitam to be there, subject-object must be there. Subject-object duality should be there for dvaitam. Brahma doesn't have. Now, if dvaitam, subject-object duality is there, in the Vyavahara it is there, subject-object duality, then how can it be advaitam? In spite of subject-object duality, the reality is advaitam. Because we dismiss the subject-object duality as mithya. It is mithya, it doesn't have paramarthika satta, it doesn't have absolute reality. It is an empirical reality. For transaction to happen, there must be a duality, subject-object, difference must be there. That is not there for the Brahma. Even if this is subject-object, what we see, the Vyavahara, the transaction, it is not Satyam. Satyam is Advaitam only. So for Advaitam, to understand Advaitam, we need not reduce all the dvaitam to advaitam. The reduction of dvaita objects, dvaita vastu to advaita is not possible. How will you reduce? We enjoy the empirical transaction. At the same time, we understand advaitam. This needs to be understood. Then only our vyavahara in the world also will be keeping in with the vision of the Shastra. In spite of subject-object difference, subject-object duality, satyam, aham satyam, aham brahma, advaita brahma, satyam, then only the transaction in the world will be in keeping with the tatparyam of the shastram, and it will be a sane transaction. If you appreciate dvaitam, the transaction will be insane. Samsara is going to be the problem. Therefore, Brahma is agragyam agragakam. Therefore, Brahma is nityam. It is not a subject and the object. It is above subject and above object. First you say it is not an object, fine. But it is not a subject also. For object to be there, subject must be there. So if subject is satya, then also it's a problem. If subject is there, then objects must be there. So we have to negate both. That is why agragyam agragakam, Bhashyakara says. It is neither the subject nor the object. The subject-object is not there. And what is that? It is nityam. It is permanent. Therefore, it is avinashi. therefore it is avinashi. Kartrutvam nasti, karmatvam nasti, therefore avinashi. Bhashyakara uses all these words. You can connect with the Gita. Avinashi tu tat viddhi ena sarvam idam tatam vinasham avyayasyasya akaschit kartum harhati. The Gita, from the shloka onwards, the nainam chintanti shastrani onwards, we have seen this in detail. All these ideas you can see here. All these ideas are presented. The same ideas are presented. Brahma is same. Every time when we discuss, we have to discuss the same thing only, not new thing. Again and again restating so that our understanding gets better. So, agragyam agragakam. Ataha yataha agragyam agragyam agragakam. Since it is, yataha is the hetu. Therefore, etumat nityam. Why it is nityam? Why it is nityam? Because it is agragyam, it is agragakam. Agragyatvat, agragakatvat, nityatvam asti brahmanaha. Yataha, yataha means yasmat, since. Evam, in this manner. What manner? That refer before what was described. Yataha, because of this. Agragyam, agragakam. Tataha or ataha, therefore Brahma is nityam, avinashi, nashaha na vidyate. There is no destruction possible for Brahma. Iti Vashikara says, we can stop here. We'll continue the Vashyam the next class. Om Purnamadav Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate. Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.
Dhanyavad Guruji.
Dhanyavad
Guruji.
Dhanyavad.